Okay, we're going to go ahead and start our first career here in IL-2 Sturmovik Hardcore Instant Death Murder Mode and see how long we can last. Hopefully at least one video. So, this is an old career. I can go ahead and delete that. That was dead anyway. But I do want to talk about my pilot first. This is our first pilot, Jerf McDurf. And he will be flying, that was a test for the USMC. We're going to be flying for the United States Marine Corps. Same difficulty settings as everything else, as the test mission there. And we're going to be starting at probably Guadalcanal, which will have us flying an F4. Eventually, when we get to Iwo Jima, if we get to Iwo Jima, it's extremely unlikely that we will survive Guadalcanal. So we'll be flying a plane that is sadly inferior in every single way to the one that we were already flying. So our birthplace will be, that would be ironic. we'll make our birthplace be, we'll be born in Utah. I don't know. First state that comes to mind. I always say that in a joking way. There are only one per option for these earlier ones. We could start all the way at Wake Island, but that's usually just kind of boring. When you start at Wake or Midway, you fly out of an aircraft carrier. In Guadalcanal, you're flying out of Henderson Field. So it'll give us an opportunity to do some landings and takeoffs without having to do it on an aircraft carrier. However, Iwo Jima, Chichijima, and Okinawa will all be flying off of an aircraft carrier. So should we get that far, we'll be in some shit. So, having said that, let's get our butts to Guadalcanal. So here's Henderson Field, right here, on the northern coast of Guadalcanal. And we've got the Florida Islands, Tulagi, and Gavutu, as well as Savo Island. I'm sure you've heard of those if you've heard of any major battles. And Henderson Field is our one foothold. This blue line here is enemy-controlled territory. So they have Savo Island, and they have the majority of Guadalcanal, with the exception of Henderson Field, which has been secured by the United States Marine Corps. We've got Florida, Tulagi, and Gavutu, but they have access to the entire island. So this is going to be a supporting of a land invasion that we're going to be doing here. So Henderson Field, now operational. Your Marine Wing is to land there and start air operations as soon as possible. You have to protect the strip from both enemy air and naval activity. Do your best in disrupting enemy resupply efforts and ease your fellow infantrymen's pain. If you do not fail in providing cover to Henderson Field, there is no reason why we should lose control of the island. So if we keep Henderson Field, we keep the island. That's the deal. And our squadron CO is Major Patterson. October 1st, 1942, a little bit before noon, and clouds of 2,500 feet. Enemy planes are inbound, and we are to take off in a scramble immediately. Let's take a look at the roster. Here we are, very low at the bottom, Gunnery Sergeant. We're the only one that has not flown a sortie in the war yet. And Reed and Tosinski already have a couple of kills. It doesn't display land kills, so tanks or cars or aircraft or anti-aircraft emplacements that they've shot or bombed won't be listed there. And we're going to be flying with some 2nd, 1st lieutenants, as well as a captain and our Major Patterson, who's only flown 5 sorties. We probably won't fly with him a lot. We're flying with Campos, Jurgen, and Kerrigan. So Kerrigan is a 2nd lieutenant, Campos is a 1st lieutenant, and where's Jurgen? I don't know where Jurgen is. I don't see him on here. What? There he is. He's right above me. So I'll be flying on Jurgen's wing. Or no, I'll be flying on Kerrigan's wing. Either way, it's our job to make sure that they don't die. And ultimately, it's our job to make sure that these guys don't get a good attack off on Henderson Field. I don't know how much time we're going to get before the planes get here. But either way, let's go ahead and get started. Remember, not if I die, but when I die, it's all over. So, for this country anyway, for our campaign. Alright, so let's take a look at the plane we have here. I'm going to just start the engine up. This is the F4F, what were they called? Wildcat? I believe it's a Wildcat. The F6Fs were Hellcats. This is a Wildcat. And Henderson Field is a gigantic strip, so really good for practice. Our anti-aircraft guns are already firing away. Probably at incoming tanks or infantry waves. And I don't know if we can see any of the enemy air forces flying around yet, but I don't see them. We got some guys flying behind us, but we are the fourth on the wing, so we're going to be the last to go. We do have a nice rearview mirror, which will hopefully prevent what happened before. Okay. Okay. That looks like a line. Is that my... No, that's two huge waves of enemy planes. Somewhere out there, over the rainbow. Okay, no. I see them right there. You can see some planes there. I don't know if those are enemy planes. And then there's some more. You can see in between. There's a gigantic formation of them in between my chair and that little ring. I can't get it in the zoom in view. But it doesn't really matter. We're going to be taking off soon here. Oh god, what is... Apparently I just looked straight up. Still getting used to this thing. I can't see the guy in front of me. I think the guy in front of me just took off. Alright, let's get going. Yeah. Here we go! I wasn't holding onto my rudder there, so... Derp is me.
Attention, fighters! 5 o'clock!
Fighters at 5 o'clock. So that probably was a formation of fighters over there. I don't know. We're not going to know until we get up here. Yes, I know my takeoff abilities are amazing. So the other thing is that this plane has manual gears. I have to manually hit a button and raise them incrementally. They're not automatic. They're not hydraulic. They're crank-operated. You see me operating my little crank there, which is a pain in the butt. Okay, they're up. Go ahead and close our canopy. And I'm not going to bother with autopilot. Normally, I would put on autopilot, but it looks like if those are enemy planes there, and yes, they are, they're being shot at. But, okay, I can see one of their enemy planes. They're going to be strafing our guys taking off. Yeah, look at dickheads. Fucking dicks. Okay, we got to deal with this. They're going to be going really fast. We're not going very fast right now, but hopefully we can get over there and provide some support for the guys we have taking off. And they've got bombers coming, so that formation, that large formation we saw, those are probably bombers. All right. There's one of their planes there. Okay, there's one right there. He's flying right under me. Yeah, there he goes. They're going too fast, though. Alright, I'm gonna see if I can get behind one of them. There's... Is that one of ours or one of theirs? That's one of theirs. Okay, so... I think that's one of theirs. I don't know. I'm not 100% sure. There's somebody in my rearview mirror. Don't know who it is. But I hope they don't want to say hello. Okay, they're pretty far away in my rearview mirror, actually. So we're getting pretty close to this guy. I can at least make sure, because this might not be one of them. It is not one of them. That is a RAF plane? I think that's... It's flying with the USMC, but I think that is a Hurricane. Or something like it. Either way, we can use this opportunity to gain some altitude. Now, I don't know where everybody is, but those are ours. I'm going to try to gain some altitude, because fighter pilots, altitude is life. Look at that clusterfuck. Okay, did Henderson Field survive the bombing? Some of our planes were taken off before they could land, or before taken out before they could take off. And I can't use my flaps to gain altitude in this thing. Okay, yeah, that's the fight right there. Can't use too much throttle because I'm overheating already, but it's going to be a while, so I'm going to go ahead and speed up time a little bit because we've got some serious ground to gain here, and we're not quite in the fight yet. Okay, there.
I'll be right there.
I'm not quite going slow enough. There we go. No, we got our landing flaps out, so we can use that to gain altitude, but we have to go really slow. God, they're so far away. So we're going really slow, but we're gaining altitude. We're up to 2,500 already. I'm trying to manage my engine and make sure that it doesn't explode, and it will. Yeah, I know. I'm away from my formation. I don't know where they're flying to. My engine is not overheating right now. So they're heading away from Savo Island. I'm never going to be able to catch those guys. And that was a waste. Alright, so that's their formation of bombers and planes. And even if I did catch them, they would eviscerate me. So why don't I see what that is? Because that's somebody right behind me. I don't know. Those might be those British planes. And if they are, I guess I'll go with them. But, I can't identify them from this range. They could be, just Japanese planes that are late to leave. I don't know. Either way, flying over Savo Island is not a really great idea, because if we get shot down over it, we'll be captured. So, I'm gonna go ahead and request a vector to target. Ground control. This plane is extremely difficult to fly. There's also a radio delay in this version. So when I request something from ground control, they won't immediately give me a response. Vector 120 to target, so I'm going to go ahead and head that way. If those guys want to go crazy and do some shit over there, then they can, but I'm not going to bother. My engine's overheating. We don't have the altitude or the speed because I wasted time trying to chase down those guys. If I'd have been smart, what I would have done is tried to gain altitude right away. I mean, we were at a severe disadvantage. There's almost no chance that we had of providing any serious damage to them. But what I should have done is just focused on gaining altitude instead of trying to chase down some guys that were probably going around 450 to 500 kilometers per hour, where I was going at most 360. So let's get another vector to our target, because we're still pretty far away from anything right now. Now this plane is typically a carrier-based plane, so that's one of the reasons that it's so ill-equipped for typical air combat. Carrier-based planes suffered a lot of disadvantages. Alright, so we got some good speed going here. And if we're lucky, we can just coast on back home, because we should have a target just basically to head back home. I see some stuff. I don't think that there's going to be any other enemy planes around. This area over here should be under enemy control, I believe. And we might be able to find some targets of opportunity if we were feeling a little frisky. Yeah, this is all under enemy control here, so I don't want to go fiddling around getting shot down over that area there. It's possible, as it is, that they've got some anti-aircraft that's trained on me right now, just waiting for me to get in range. So I'm going to sort of fly off of the coast here. Let's put our radiator position 4 so we can get a little bit more speed. And this ought to be relatively safe flight, basically back home, from what I understand. Point Cruz is a small town coming up ahead. Yeah, we're basically going to be flying home right now. But I might want to check out Point Cruz, at least from the air. Maybe get some intel, recon, see what's going on over there. You know, while I'm in the area. So I'll speed up time a little bit.
Heading 210, altitude 01.
Don't know exactly where. Okay, Point Cruz is basically straight ahead of me. So somewhere up around here. And if they've got a concentrated armed force there, I might do some strafing runs or something like that, but again, kind of unlikely. But I've never been one to, oh, there's the town right ahead there. Never been one to shy away from a fight. My only problem is, sometimes I'm like a dog chasing a car's tire, you know, to quote the Joker. Wouldn't know what to do with it if I caught it. But still, at least we're getting a nice, peaceful flight. We get to check out the countryside and see all these little tributaries coming into the island and get a good idea of where everything is. So, I'm not getting shot at. I'm getting a little low and a little fast right now, just because I want to be able to take a nice, good look here. But not too long and not too low. That is either a longhouse. Okay. All right, I see you. I see you. You can stop now. Yeah, I'm not going to be flying near there again. But at least we know that that's there. Yes, I know my engine's overheating, and that's a problem because we're getting a little bit pounded right now. Okay, we took a couple of shots, but I don't think they're going to be able to get us. I'm going to go a little bit lower here. I see a plane up ahead, because I want to be able to reduce my speed and get out of their firing range. What is that? There's something right there. It's a vehicle.
This is one. Request permission to land.
Those are Japanese tanks!
Fuck!
Wow, that's some great luck. Well, I don't have any cannon rounds, so it's unlikely I'd be able to hurt them. But it couldn't really be... I think we might have just been injured there. I think I'm going to go around and see if we can't strafe them once or twice. They were right in front of that river there. I don't know if they were amphibious or not. There they are. Okay. This could be fun. You know. Out of gas with the, some tanks? What could possibly go wrong? It's not like I could die. Could be shot in the head through the canopy of my plane or anything. Oh, fuck. Now, the radiator on this thing, I don't know if it also serves as a dual-purpose cowl flaps, armor flaps, but in some of the planes, the radiator flaps will provide armor for the pilot when doing... Oh, come on, man!
Bombers! Get ahead! Heading 1-2-0.
Bombers.
Altitude 1-0.
Heading towards our base at an altitude of 1,200 meters, I believe. What are these guys shooting at? Okay, I'm gonna... You know what? Those tanks... They can keep doing their thing. It's unlikely that I'll be able to get anywhere near them. I want to find out what's going on here. It's possible that 1 and 2 were those two planes that I passed that were heading after that formation of bombers, but I don't know. I'm going to go ahead and cool my engine off here. Basically, right now, we can land as soon as we want, or we can continue to fly around and see if we can impact the battlefield in any way. Which I would obviously like to do. I can't tell if I'm injured, though. I'm gonna go... Yeah, I think my pilot got... Oh. Yeah. Those are bullet holes. Okay, yeah. That little red tint, that very slight red tint, you can only notice it when we switch in and out. That's what happens when your pilot is injured. Okay, so not too much damage to the field that I can see. We still got some cars and things laying around. What are these guys shooting at over here? I'm pretty sure those bombers that were called out were the ones that were flying way away from us. I don't know where they... why they decided to go all the way out there to engage them, but, I think... I'm gonna try to gain some altitude here and take a look around. Okay, 2 and 3 are heading back to the field. I really want to know what these guys are shooting at, although I don't want to get too close to whatever it is, because it's likely spiky and will shoot back. Whoa. Okay, that's a town. Might be in Japanese control. I need to trim my plane out. I got my plane trimmed for a completely different aerodynamic scenario. Alright, we got the engine cooled off. We can piddle around at about 70% for now. Calling out more bombers, but it seems like it's probably those guys really far away, because I don't see anything around Henderson. And we're just basically flying our own little patrol here. So, yeah, they're probably shooting at tanks and things out there. I could go join in, but these kind of guns, not suitable for shooting armor targets. They're incendiary ammo. So, I could probably pop one of them, but it would take a lot. And a while, and probably not be worth it. I'm just going to go ahead and radio in for a landing here.
You are cleared for landing.
All right, we've been cleared for landing. There's 800 million miles of airstrip right there, so shouldn't really have a problem getting down onto it. Oops, I just paused the game. I went to open my canopy. And now we can start cranking. Yeah, this airstrip is so huge, I don't know how you could not land on it. Alright, we got our gear down. Only problem is that we're a little too high and a little too fast. Which I think is the same problem Cheech and Chong had. It looks like there's somebody in the middle of the runway, so I'm going to go ahead and take this lane over here. Set it down nice and gentle. I don't know if that's somebody else that's already landed, or I know some of our planes were killed while attempting to take off. Okay, I see some of our guys taxiing. So we got guys taxiing up ahead. Oh. I would love to... Oh, no. I would love to know what 1 and 2 are up to. Yeah, we lost some... Are those B-17s? Holy shit. That's not good. I did not miss my turn. But... Alright, so we've landed safely. That was our hidden target. Don't really know where the rest of my flight is. I guess we're gonna go ahead and taxi off the runway a little bit. These things have foldable wings as well for easier storage on a carrier. Might as well fold them up. Don't know what controls that though. Okay, so who is he?
This is 3. Requesting permission to land, sir.
He's one of my... I think he might be one of my wing. So I'm 4, 3 is landing. I don't know if those guys that... I'm pretty sure those guys that we heard there were those two people in either Seafires or Spitfires or whatever the hell they were. I'm probably getting that identification all wrong, but all the same. It was a pretty uneventful mission for us. We didn't get a lot of opportunity to do anything cool, although we did get shot. No kills, no positive actions, though we didn't do anything really negative. We didn't contribute much other than getting shot, and I don't think we're going to get any promotions for that. But let's go ahead and log this one in the books and see what has become of it. So, Lieutenant Kerrigan got 3 kills. Let's see here. Where did they... Yeah, I knew it. They were all the way out here. Yep, it was. They caught up to those formations. Shot down by a P-400. I don't know what that is. It looked sort of like a P-40, but... I don't know what a P-400 is. And then... We had a bunch of their planes were shot down. And some of our aircraft were destroyed, and one of our aircraft that was taking off was also destroyed. But it looks like they suffered the most here. They lost 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. I don't know if that A6M221 is a zero or not, but... Yeah, this is what they were firing at, some tanks out there, and then I played with some tanks over here, near Point Cruz, right about here, and hopefully they didn't make much headway in attacking us. So, next time we'll go ahead and apply this, and move on to the next day, or it might even still be the same day, and continue on with the career. I think, no, I'll apply it here, and then we'll see if there's anything that came of it. No. So next time, we're going to be doing a convoy attack, I believe, or a convoy attack escort. We're going to be escorting B-17s. So join me for that, where it's less likely that I'll just fly around at random, because we're going to have a designated flight path instead of a scramble. See you then!